As we discussed last class about the design consideration of breast excavation, first one is your bottom heave formation or bottom heave. It occurs generally in cohesive soil . Let us say this is a cohesive soil and this part is your ground surface. And this is your height h of the excavation height h, and this is your overburden gamma h, and this you can say that bearing capacity failure. Bearing capacity failure, then this comes as a heave. For homogeneous soil clay, Q ultimate for clay, Q ultimate is equal to Cu Nc. Cu is your undrained cohesion, and for critical depth, gamma Sc is equal to Cu Nc. This is your critical depth. So that means HC is equal to Cu Nc by gamma, and you can write it down like this: gamma HC by Cu, which is equal to Nc. Generally, the value of Nc is 5.726. So, gamma Sc by Cu, it is called stability number. Stability number. If stability number or stability factor, is greater than Nc, then failure occurs. For a factor of safety of, say, 1.5, you can write out gamma H by Cu, which is equal to Nc by 1.5, which is equal to 4. Now, what does it mean if you look at there? If you remember well, last class we discussed about the one of the design criteria or design consideration is about your bottom heave. This bottom heave generally occurs in what kind of soil? Generally, it occurs in case of cohesive soil. How the bottom heave has been formed? As you go more the deep, more depth you cut, vertical cut means below the ground surface, then what happens? This overburden pressure will increase. Because of this increase in overburden pressure below the cut, what will happen? This soil will fail by means of bearing capacity. Once this soil will fail, then nearby soil will be pushed, so that there will be a heave formation, in the excavation. So, this is your excavation. This shaded area is your completely excavation, and in this excavation, once there is a heave formation, heave means the soil from the bottom, will come inside your underground excavation. Once this thing has been occurred, what will happen? Whatever the structure constructed here, like metro rail underground, so it will also fail, So to start with this, understand this phenomena, let us say for this cohesive soil, what is your bearing capacity? For cohesive soil, bearing capacity is purely cohesive soil, there is no phi. Cnc or Cunc. Cu is your undrained cohesion. then this CUNC is nothing, you have to equate it to critical height. Critical height. Critical height. So that means it is not in a kind of critical height. If you equate it into, this will be your gamma SC, critical depth or critical height. So this CUNC depends upon your critical depth. Now from there critical height is coming, SC is equal to CUNC by gamma. If I take this all the terms, gamma SC by CU, this is called stability factor. Gamma SC by CU, this is called stability factor, which is equal to NC. That means this NC value is generally for bearing capacity factor, for cohesion value, for purely cohesive soil it is 5.7 to 6. That means gamma SC by CU, this is your stability number or stability factor, which is, if it is this stability number or stability factor, if it is greater than NC, if it is greater than NC, that means failure occur for cohesive soil. Failure occur means what will happen? There will be a bottom heap formation. That means this is the condition, the stability number or factor, it should be less than equal to NC, it should not greater than your bearing capacity factor for cohesive soil. Now for example, in Calcutta soil CU is equal to 2.5 ton per meter square, and H generally cut, typical example I am taking in Calcutta metro, H is equal to 10 meters say, height of cut excavation. So gamma H by CU, which is equal to, gamma is equal to 1.8 into H is equal to 10 by 2.5, which is equal to 7.2 greater than NC. That means if there is a underground construction in Calcutta soil, there is a chance that bottom heave will be formed, bottom heave formation will be there. So this is your first criteria, first design consideration, that is your bottom heap. Then another example, this is, you can say that this is a uniform soil. Suppose this soil is purely uniform, there is no layered soil, that means a constant value of CU is there, this is your calculation. Now if I go for second example, so how do you prevent, before I solve the second example, how do you prevent? The prevent will be, you have to dewater from the cohesive soil, so that water table will go below your, far below this there, so that it will become harder, slightly harder, so that bearing capacity failure may be avoided. So example 2, there are 6 layers of soil. As I said, this is not a uniform soil layer. So layer 1 is your farm clay. Layer 2 is your soft clay, CU is equal to 2.5 ton per meter square. Layer 3, again it is farm clay, CU is equal to 6 ton per meter square. Then layer 4 is your sandy silt, and layer 5 is your stiff clay, Cu is equal to 10 ton per meter square, and layer 6 is equal to your dense sand. Now there is a chance that there is a cutoff up to sandy silt, that means vertical cutoff. You do the vertical ground excavation, you go for, if there, these are your, all your soft soil, at what depth you can go for your vertical excavation, where you are getting a kind of hard stratum. This is sandy silt or dense sand, you can go here. So if I try with this, there is a vertical cut in excavation up to sandy silt. Let us say with this sandy silt, say this is your DF, this is your DF, and this is your kind of, you can write H, and let us put it layer by layer, layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, layer 1 is equal to gamma 1 Cu 1, gamma 2 Cu 2, gamma 3 Cu 3, then from there it starts like this, then let us say this is my case of D 1, then this is gamma 4 and Cu 4, then if it is coming in this way up to the middle, the bearing capacity failure I am showing up to this middle like this. So let us say the failure envelope from here you can extend up to B 1, and here it will be completely B. Now factor of safety is equal to Cu Nc plus gamma Df plus Cu H by B 1 by gamma H plus Df. So that means this is your all stabilizing forces divided by all disturbing forces. All disturbing forces, then what will happen? The factor of safety greater than 2.0, it will be okay. If the factor of safety is coming out to be for against your bottom, if it is greater than 2.0, then it is okay. So what we are basically doing, we are taking a influence line, influence of failure envelope here up to a distance B 1, and this is, if this is B, here a distance B 1. How to calculate B 1? So B 1 is equal to B by root 2 and D 1. From there it is your lower value. If you look at here, first we check your stability number and factor, it should be greater than Nc, so that if it is greater than Nc, then failure will occur. Based on that you can calculate your factor of safety. For finding out factor of safety, let us say this is an excavation, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 number of layers, and our two positions, our fourth number of layer, this is a sandy silt, and sixth position is a dense sand. So that means your excavation you can extend from here to here, or excavation you extend from here to here. That means the base of your excavation, till excavation where you are doing up to that depth, it should be ensure that up to that depth, at that depth there is a hard stratum lying. That means this is your hard stratum lying sandy silt or dense sand. So what happened? I am taking a, this is my involvement, D1 is your influence area based on your bearing capacity. So once you are getting D1, then there will be depth of foundation, this will be also given, height also given, B also given. Only you have to find it out B1 and D1. So D1 will be come, it will come based on your bearing capacity calculation. Then once you get D1, then you can check your factor of safety. Your factor of safety is equal to, there are 5 layers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 layers. That means Cu1, Nc1, Cu2, Nc2, all 4 you calculate, plus gamma df, gamma into depth of foundation, gamma depth of this depth, gamma df, plus Cuh by B1. This Cunc, this Cunc is your, this one is your Cunc, and Cuh by B1, this summation of Cuh by B1 by gamma h plus df divided by gamma h plus df. If you look at here, all stabilizing forces divided by all disturbing forces, all stabilizing forces divided by all disturbing forces, from there you have to find it out, your factor of safety is equal to 2.0, and B1 you are going to calculate, B1 is equal to B by root 2 or D1. B1 is equal to, as it is given, B and D, so B by root 2 or D1, that means which is lower, lower value of B1 you are supposed to take it. This is for design consideration of bottom heave. The next part is your clay busting. How to calculate factor of safety for your bottom heave, this has been done. Then for clay busting, what is the condition for clay bursting? Clay bursting means clay soil sample will come out along with the water. If there is a clay layer of shallow depth, then there is a water table, then water table is at ground surface, then below the shallow depth of clay, if there is a kind of sandy soil or sand, then there is a chance of clay bursting. In this case, the factor of safety, how come this clay bursting will come? The sand will give upward movement. The sand will give upward movement. If you look at here, this is a clay of a shallow depth of the clay layer is there, then here there is a sand layer. So once you start excavation, that means you completely excavate and small part above your sand you are there, you are stopping there, what will happen, this sand along with this water, it will make upward force. So what will happen, mixture of sand and clay, it will come up in the excavation. So you have to stop the clay bursting. Clay burst means it will burst out and puncture, and the clay will come out from this excavation. That is the meaning. So what is the factor of safety you should take it? The factor of safety is equal to gamma d plus 2 Cu d by b divided by gamma w h plus d, which is equal to greater than 1.3. gamma d, gamma times into d, gamma times into depth of d, plus 2 Cu d, 2 times Cu d into b, it is nothing but Cu d by b by 2. So this b by 2, this 2, because this half of the part will be taken into consideration. So once this half of part has taken into consideration, so b by 2, that means the 2 has gone there. So 2 Cu d by b. Then for upward thrust, this is your upward thrust. Upward thrust will be gamma w into h plus d. Gamma w is your unit weight of water, and h plus d is your this height, up to this height, it is applying your upward thrust. So this factor of safety should be greater than 1.3 for design consideration of clay bursting. That means each case we have to check this, whether this factor of safety is satisfying or not. If it is not satisfying, then this design has to be changed. Then that means the depth has to be changed, or other criteria, the struts has to be provided very close to each other.